It's so nice to see you after all these years.
It's nice to see you after 3 Christmases.
I would have to say. All right, first, where do you live in Canada? Exactly.
I live in a town called Coquitlam in the Tri-Cities.
Okay. And how long have you been in Canada already? You left the entertainment scene in 1995.
I left in 26 years, yes. Wow. Pero umuwi naman ako. So awan ng Diyos, nakaka-uwi naman ako all those 26 years. God had blessed me naman with Valentine concerts and little shows. So at least nakikita ko pa rin kayo. Nakita ko pa rin magandang Pilipinas.
Okay. All right. Now, I grew up with your songs. I mean, Tell Me, I Remember the Boy, all these songs. But we'll talk about your concert later. The life you have in Canada all these years, I know that you put up a preschool. Is that correct?
A daycare.
Let's
a Catholic daycare.
Let's talk about your life there.
You know what, Karen? I'm so blessed kasi I have the best of both worlds. I'm blessed in a way na naalala pa ako ng mga Pilipino for who I was in the Philippines. And yet, I'm also blessed with a beautiful family life here. And they were not easy. The adjustment was, I'm not gonna lie, the adjustment was not easy, not by all means. Having to learn to run your own household, take care of your own children, cook, clean, toilets, drive around, which I wasn't very good at. It wasn't very easy. I had to deal with so much, and then having to get sick here. I didn't have the luxury of having maids and my mom here. And so there was a lot that I might have wished. A lot of times I might have wished otherwise, but at the end of 26 years and after seeing my children grow up into very beautiful, independent children who have become women of their own substance, it's all worthwhile. All the sacrifices are worthwhile. And I understand why people leave and make sacrifices for their families.
You know, it also takes courage to venture into a life that you don't know, but also takes a lot of courage to also leave the showbiz life. I mean, let's face it, showbiz has its own trappings. People like being famous, you know, people loving you, calling your name, earning so much money from singing or acting. And it takes courage to walk away from all of that. What made you do it? What was that tipping point?
You know, I never talk enough about how painful it was. Yeah. But I will have to say, and I admitted this in the concert, that I'm going to admit it in the concert. I admit it in every concert. Only when it's, you know, live and intimate, that it really was the second most painful time in my life. After my losing my mom, it was very painful. It literally felt like you're standing on stage with so much people applauding you, and then suddenly nag-brown out. Parang ganun. Dilim. Kumakita. It was very difficult. It was very painful. And, you know, I never wanted to let people to know in Manila kasi I don't want them. Then I didn't want that. It was nakakahiya. It was embarrassing to admit that it, you know, and people might say, oh, tinamo, malis-alis ka kasi. And I didn't want to have to face that then because I wasn't ready. I was dealing with enough. Remember that when I left in 1995, I just had my first cancer. So it was a bit too much for me, no? So I just pretended na lang that everything was okay. Mm-hmm. But it wasn't. I think I cried for about 3 years.
Wow. Yeah. Would you say that it was God's purpose for you to leave?
Definitely.
Okay.
God has, everything that happens to us is God's purpose, even the hard ones, even the hard times. Because can you imagine, after I left, I had cancer 2 more times. And I could be in no better place than here. having to face cancer.
Yes, and you're talking about, of course, the healthcare, you know, the protection that's offered in Canada. Yes. And looking back, you're right, because here you are, you're healthy and with your family. It could have been maybe another story.
Yes, it could have been, it could have all turned out differently.
Yeah. And what's amazing is after all these years, you still sing, you know, that's the amazing part, is your first love is singing. And you have a digital concert soon. And this digital concert, let's talk about it, is July 11. But what makes this any different from your other concerts?
First of all, it's digital. And for someone my age, it's going to be a bit nerve-wracking because I'm so used to... Tandaan mo, laking banda ako. I started my career in singing in front of people. Like, they're one foot away from me. And so I yun lang ang alam ko, yung live stage. So ninenervous ako dito kasi digital. At 60 years old na ako. Hindi, nakaka-nervous ito mga ganito. Yan, yan.
I agree. Yeah.
Nakakatakot. Ikaw sanay ka na sa TV, so that's okay, diba? Kaminda. So that's one. And I guess the other difference is that I'll be singing the songs 40 years later. You know, I stand the chance that people are going to say, oh, ganyan na yung boses niya, siguro. I mean, I am opening myself up to a lot of criticism, but it was really Moy Ortiz that said, Joe, you have to do it because not many people reach 40 years and are still remembered. So you have a lot to be thankful for. So yun, and then exciting kasi baliktad na rin yung mundo, right? You know, now it's the kids directing. So my directors are from the Philippines, Paolo Valenciano, the son of Gary. And here my own daughter Trixie is going to direct. Because my daughter Trixie is also in the film industry here. So so I am.
What's amazing are your songs really remain relevant after all these years. I mean, regardless of the generation, your songs can cross over. I'll be honest. Like, for example, your song Points of View. Right?
That's Freddy Santos lyrics.
Points of View is technically, it speaks to anyone going through that situation.
Okay. Friendship.
I actually read your repertoire and it seems you're not singing you are singing Tell Me. Tell Me can never go away. Yeah.
No. You know, Karen, that people always ask me how I feel about that. And I really have no answer. It's a God-given phenomenon. I really, really cannot wrap my still after 40 years and after 25 years, I cannot wrap my head around why people remember me after I left.
Yeah,
I'm so far away.
Yeah. And let me ask you, this is an interesting question for all artists. Okay, here you are after 40 years. Filipinos still know you. They know your songs, and your songs are still played, and it's earning. Do you still receive compensation in terms
only,
you know, monetary,
financially?
Yes,
only for the
financial.
Only for the ones I wrote lyrics for. Yun lang yung natatang. Yeah, I think by law yun lang yung entitled ako.
Oh, but it's different in the United States, huh?
Very different. You have one hit here and you sit pretty for the rest of your life.
I was going to say.
Kasi dito, even if you have... Even if you didn't write it, even the there's such a thing as performance royalties here.
And you believe, okay, looking back now, I mean, you believe it's time to also include that in the Philippines?
Well, I do believe. And I think they're already working on it. Alam hindi naman nagpapaiwan ng Pilipinas. So I really think that now is the time to work on it because, you know, now, especially after the pandemic, there are more people with all these new mediums and platforms for music. There's so many more young people writing songs. So now is the time to get all these royalty laws and copyright laws right.
Yeah.
We've had it wrong for so long.
Yeah.
So now is the time. There's a lot of fresh blood, new artists braving the new platforms. And I think that, you know, the industry owes it to them.
To give them
a good future.
In Canada, do you sing?
Yes.
Okay.
Not professionally. Here, for about 10 years, nagtayo ako ng maliit na banda in a nice hotel. Yeah. And on weekends, we sing, people come, they dance. And, you know, for me, it was just for the pure joy of it. And then even with the pandemic, I have this little Joey's Jams on my Facebook. So every Saturday
for
the last year, wala lang, I turn on my Facebook, tas bilyads kakantahan talaga, you know.
And more than that, you have that Dear Joey on Facebook, right?
And I have Dear Joey.
But have you started a YouTube channel?
That is my YouTube channel. So Dear Joey is a small YouTube channel. And what I came up with this idea, and dami-daming kayang malungkot sa Pilipinas. Ano kaya? Because I've always also wanted to do a little dear. Di ba yung, dear, ano? Eh, ano yan?
Yeah, yeah. Like, dear Ate Helen, dear Charo, kind.
I've always wanted to do a newspaper. And I said, hey, this is a new platform now. And everybody's doing the Zoom thing. So I said, try ko kaya sa and so what happens is they write me letters and then I sing them a song. Simple, nothing complicated.
Wow. So can you sing me a song? Can you sing
a song? You'll have to give me a problem first.
Okay. Well, okay. Let's put it to Dear Joey. Many people in the Philippines. So ito yung problem. Okay. Dear Joey, many people in the Philippines are experiencing lockdown fatigue, unsure about the future, with fear and anxiety. And sometimes they don't know where to look. Politically, it's also unpredictable in the Philippines at this point. With ABS-CBN, no one knows the future. So how's that to encompass, right? That whole feeling of uncertainty. Can you? What will you sing?
Muna kakantahan kita ng Here I am, I haven't gone that far away, and since I am, magkakantahan kita niya. Or maybe I'd sing them a song like
And that would be, is Here I Am a Christian song? It's meant to be.
No, that's part of my song points of view.
But then I know yeah. It's your song portfolio, but was it written also
as a Christian?
No, okay.
Freddie Santos really wrote that because Octoarts needed a song for me and Pops to sing, and Pops and I, so Pops and I were pretty close friends that time. So Freddie said, I'll write a song about friendship that should last.
I love
Freddie
that.
Santos.
What else would you sing? Sige pa, another song.
That's
enough to be
sing
your song.
So I lift my hands and pray to be only yours. I pray to be only yours. I know now you're my only hope. Ganda-ganda nun from Mandy Moore.
Naiyak naman ako. I know that, the movie. Yeah,
I would sing them a song about hope. So I would just maybe, or a song about friends, or a song about, you know, just dapat kantahin ko pala yung kanta ni Gary, yung Hang On. Hang On.
Clearly, you also want to do something that it's not just for the money, but you want to sing to encourage people, it seems, because why would you put up your Facebook and YouTube, right?
You know, and the thing is also it gave me an opportunity and the forum to address my helplessness. My earthquake, and just recently to help my mommy's priests raise funds for the community pantries. So gagawin ko mag-Facebook live. So I sing for mga 4 hours on Facebook. Tapos bahala na si Batman kung sino.
It's pretty long. Yeah.
It's very long. And then my team, Sinavigan Russia, my contrast team, they put all these of how they can donate, and then to my mom's priests, and And siguro, of maybe 3 or 4 fundraisers, the Filipinos, you know, ang galing kasi ng mga Pinoy, pag nakakita sila ng ganyan, they really give. So siguro, Pinoys, through my Facebook live efforts, siguro altogether we've raised, including pa the one with Chad Borja, siguro altogether we, in the last whole pandemic year and a half, I've probably contributed close to 5 million pesos.
Bravo.
Yeah, so, you know, it's a good opportunity. It's a good opportunity, and it's a good way to show people you can never say that there's nothing you can do, because yeah, there's always something.
Uh-oh.
There's always something we can do, diba?
Yeah. Always. You honestly look so happy. It's like your eyes are smiling. You know, your spirit is glowing.
Walang drama dito.
Oh, yun nga, walang drama. Oh my God!
Kaya balik ka na dito, halik ka na, asking ka na ulit.
Oh my God, oo nga, walang drama dyan, no?
Diba, saya-saya natin pag nandito tayo, kain lang tayo nakain.
Oo, I remember, can we share that? Let's share that. So, last 2014, no?
Yes.
Last 2014, I spent Christmas in Whistler, in Canada, with Kuya Kim Atienza.
Yes.
And we had breakfast with Joey. And you already looked so happy then. Yeah. You've never aged.
Oh, no, thank you. I have. Tsaka nga, buti lang itong Zoom hanggang dito lang. Bunin tignan yung blue.
Before we go, Joey, I'd like you to invite everybody. Can you invite everybody for the concert? Okay? So, yes. Let's give the details.
Buong Pilipinas, manood po kayo July 11. I'm celebrating my 40 years in the industry, which all of you have made successful for me. Kung hindi naman dahil sa inyong lahat, well, hindi naman po akabot ng 40 years. So this is my thank you sa inyong lahat. Sana manood kayo and manood kayo na aking thank you for you. This will be on July 11, 8 p.m. Manila time, with international global streaming on July 12. Between 9 a.m. and 3 p.m. Manila time, and whatever time that is in whatever country you are in the world. And this is brought to you by KTX Philippines. Mm-hmm. So I'm really, really both nervous and very excited. And what a wonderful opportunity to celebrate 40 years. I can't think of a greater blessing than 40
and I
years.
Would say, Joey, your life alone is an inspiration and a living testimony. So I have to say your very presence makes, I mean, it lightens up the screen. So thank you.
Thank you so much. I guess, you know, we just have to really be positive and become a light to each other. That's all we can do.
All right. Thank you so much. Hey, Joey, I hope to see you soon.
Yeah, so good to see you. Take care.
All right. God bless you. God bless you. All right.